Welcome. Today I would like to discuss the rules pattern that can also be applied to C sharp. So essentially what it is that you define an interface iRule. Here is the definition, and you can indicate whether the rule is applicable or not. And if the rule is applicable, you can execute some kind of a function on it. And to define the concrete rules A, B, and C, essentially you can have a class which inherits from iRule and implement those methods. That's the theory behind it. And in terms of how you can execute the rules, basically what you can do is you can have like a rules evaluator. And the rules evaluator would have a list of rules that it would get in its constructor. And when it is told to execute, you can get some context or state. And you'll essentially do a for loop through the rules. And you first check if rule is applicable. If rules is applicable, you get some result and apply. So that's kind of the theory. So let's be done with the theory for now and take a concrete example here. So I've already prepared a program, and I can show you what it is doing. If you see the program, it is printing some hello world, and then it just gets a context. And the context, and it populates a date, which is today, and then adds minus one to it. And here we are creating the rules, and we only have one rule here called the verb tenses. So here we got the rules. And we feed this rules to the rules evaluator. Here we are feeding it to the rules evaluator, this rules, which is just one rule, and executing it and printing some results. So if I run this program, you can see it will give me the result saying that the tense we can use for the verb is in the past, because this date is in the past, today minus one. And that's pretty much all it does here right now. So let me show you the iRules here again. Is applicable, takes in a context, returns whether it's true or not. And then it, when you execute it, it basically returns some kind of a string. So if you want to take a quick look at the rule, this one also, so let's just go there. So this is a concrete implementation of a verb tenses rule. And if we check if it's applicable, if the date is, say, let's say the min value, that means it's not really a date we want to worry about, we'll return a false. Otherwise, we'll return a true. And when we execute the rule, it is doing this thing. When if it, the date in the context is less than today, we'll say it's in the past. And then we set context in past is equal to false, this value, because in this case it has the default value, which is true. And if it's today, then it returns present in future. So this could actually be used for cases where you wanted to figure out what tense to use or verb tense to use. That's why the name of this class is called verb tense. If you look at the rules evaluator, it's pretty straightforward. It gets all these rules in its constructor. And here we say, we only select the rules which are applicable, because we don't want to try to run the rules which are not applicable and say where the rules are applicable. And then we select the rules which are ready for execution or should be executed. And we get the results in here. And here we're just taking the results to list, and we are enumerating over the list and printing to the output of the rule. So that's pretty much what it is. So let's say if we wanted to expand this a little bit and wanted to add another rule, let's say we call it the fact check. So to do that would be pretty straightforward. Since it's a rule, we want to inherit from iRule. Let me just cut it here and add it here. So we want to inherit from iRule, and it says we want to now implement the interface. So we are here in the interface. Is applicable is pretty, because it's a fact check, we only want to do fact checks on things that are in the past. So let me just copy just a very small amount of code to see what should be in the fact check. So we will say that this rule is applicable if it is in the past. The context is already set to past, so that makes sense. In the constructor, what we want to do is we want to have some facts database. And for simplicity, I only have a very simple facts here. Some things about World War I, and which is basically two dates. So let me just copy those And if I copy those, what we are doing is initializing these events and generate read-only field. And we generated the events to keep the compiler happy, and that's pretty much it. And if you want to look at the dates which are there, if you look at these dates, are this was the start of World War One, and this is the start end of World War One. So we got basically just two facts in our database, and this is information about the past tenses, the verb tenses, how you can decide which verb to use in the past, present, or future. So that could be also useful. So let's say now we got our fact check. Is applicable is good, and we want to execute some information once the rule is applicable. And I've given an example, and let me copy that example here and save you some time here. And the example is pretty straightforward. If you look at it, what it is saying is event contains these the date that is given, then we can say it is the start of World War One or end of World War One. If the date is between the first date in the events and the last date, that means it's during World War One. And otherwise, we can say information is not in the fact database. So we got this fact check rule, and we just want to add it to our rule, so we can do that. And to add that is pretty straightforward. We can just say new fact check, and we added another rule. So that's all nice and done. And to get some other results, I'm going to change this date to be start of World War One or Two, so that way we get a different result. So what I'm going to do is just copy this date. This is start of World War One. So you'll copy it in here in the context. And that's all we did. And now let's say I clear this information and run the program again. You should see that it should print that this thing is in the past. Obviously, this is in the past, and it is either start of World War One or start of World War One or end of World War One, and is in the past. And especially if I change this date, say 2014, and it will behave a little bit differently. So it's not in the past. Well, I guess it's still in the past, but. Information is not in the fact database, and you could add more and more rules. So this is actually a pretty good example of how to use rules in C#. And what I'm going to do is I will add this to my website under Gore Associates and C# rules, or maybe I'll just add it under C# instead of visitor design pattern. I'll say C# rule design pattern, and how many minutes it took me to do this video. And thank you for watching this video. Great.